Well, that was fast. Hi guys, what's up? Your boy Al is here with episode 2 review of ReZero season 3 part 1, so let's go. At first we see Subaru regain his composure after another revival through his return by death ability. As he prepares to express gratitude to his allies, he's haunted by memories of Sirius thanking a crowd before mercilessly killing them. Liliana's speech continues, and Subaru realizes that his reset point is just before Sirius' brutal plan unfolds. Initially, he considered bringing Beatrice with him but, recalling Emilia's previous ordeal with Petalgeuse, he decides Beatrice should stay with Emilia for her safety while he faces Sirius alone. Emilia expresses concern for his safety, but Subaru reassures her. Subaru climbs the clock tower in search of Luzbel but finds no trace of Sirius. Suddenly, their eyes glow red as Sirius appears behind him, activating her abilities. She praises Subaru's kindness before trapping him with her chain-like weapon, which slices his fingers when he tries to break free. It's kinda scary to think just how powerful the spell was that it took, Subaru of all people, some time to realize what has happened even after coming back to life. Also not gonna lie, I'm kinda liking the crazy nature of Sirius. We see Sirius express her gratitude and apologize while delivering a monologue about kindness and love. Her powers amplify emotions and sensations among her targets, even extending to physical injuries. Amid the chaos, Subaru voices his fear of death, reminding himself that this fear reaffirms his humanity. Sirius likewise raves about fear and other emotions, leading to Subaru's death once again. Following his revival through return by death, Subaru is more determined than ever to seek help and concludes that Reinhardt would be the ideal ally. Subaru convinces Rakens to summon Reinhardt, emphasizing the imminent threat posed by the witch's cult. Rakens activates a signal in the sky to attract Reinhardt's attention, but the timing is unfortunate as Sirius makes her announcement to the crowd, diverting their focus. Subaru falls under her influence, mirroring the earlier events. However, Reinhardt bursts onto the scene just in time, breaking both Rakens and Subaru free from her enchantment. Subaru quickly briefs Reinhardt on the situation, and Sirius recognizes him as the master swordsman. Without hesitation, Reinhardt dives into battle, launching a relentless assault against her. Meanwhile, Subaru manages to rescue Luzbel as Reinhardt nearly incapacitates Sirius, with the crowd still chanting for her demise under her spell. I understand Subaru was in a rush for time, but at this point he should be able to remain calm in these situations, so I don't really get why he didn't even bother listening to what the kid was trying to tell him. Moving on, we see that realizing something is wrong, Subaru senses danger as Reinhardt prepares to deliver the final blow to Sirius. Tragically, he succumbs to her magic again, leading to a disastrous outcome where both Sirius and the crowd, including Reinhardt, appear to be bisected, despite Reinhardt's supposed resilience to her witch factor. Subaru revives once more through return by death, visibly frustrated and disturbed by Reinhardt's unexpected defeat. He decides to take Beatrice along for a shopping trip, during which she senses that something is off. Priscilla also picks up on the underlying tension as Subaru explains the situation to Beatrice, who accepts his judgment without hesitation. I absolutely love this part, because it showed that even if someone is too overpowered, they still can be defeated by a weaker opponent, and ReZero is just totally the best in showcasing this aspect of the story. Then we see Subaru elaborate on Sirius' powers, explaining how they transmit feelings and sensations, making individuals unable to perceive threats. Moreover, any injuries she suffers are mirrored by everyone under her spell. Beatrice argues that collaborating with Reinhardt would be futile since his powers render her ineffective, as all surrounding mana obeys his will. Beatrice suggests using Shamak to negate the spell's effects on the afflicted, allowing Sirius to be defeated without endangering others. At that moment, Emilia arrives, apologizing for not following Subaru's wishes. She explains that Priscilla warned her that the regrets of inaction would linger if she delayed pursuing Subaru. He tries to convince her to retreat, but his plea is in vain. Emilia insists that whenever Subaru enters combat, she must stand by his side, as her desire to protect him equals his own. Subaru relents but warns her to prioritize her safety due to the witch's cult's obsession with her. Just then, Sirius appears on top of the clock tower, prompting Emilia to launch an immediate retaliatory strike with her ice magic. It's really heartbreaking to see Emilia and Sirius fight like that, but I won't say why, just in case people still haven't figured who Sirius actually is. Also, it was great to see Emilia stand her own ground, because it shows just how much she has grown as a person. At the end, we see Beatrice point out that Shamak would be ineffective against Sirius due to the spiritual nature of her power. Meanwhile, the nearby citizens remain trapped under Sirius' spell, unaffected by Emilia's attack. Enraged by Emilia's interference, Sirius leaps down, revealing an unexpected fury. Subaru observes this new emotional outburst from her. Through her tirade, it becomes clear that Petalgius was her spouse, and she blames Emilia for stealing and ending his life. The ensuing battle shows Emilia not only defending herself but also pushing Sirius back. Just as Sirius retaliates, Regulus Corneus intervenes, saving Emilia and retrieving her. The only reason Subaru hasn't gone insane is because Emilia is still with him, but now that someone is trying to take her away from him, Subaru will obviously try to stop that from happening, but I wonder how he will deal with two archbishops at the same time. Nonetheless, it was a great action-packed episode with a touch of character growth. By the way, episode 3 is already out, and I'm really sorry for the delays, but things are a bit hectic for me right now, so the uploads won't be very timely until next month, so I hope you guys will understand. Anyways, thanks for watching, everyone. If you like my video, then check out some of my other videos. Also, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to my channel if you want to keep me motivated to make more videos, and you can also leave a comment if you want to say something, because it helps me fight the almighty YouTube algorithm. You can also follow me on Twitter and Instagram or check out my Facebook page, links are given in the description. Until then, see ya.